Welcome back to AGS Channel 1. Up next, everybody's favourite Ross Kemp on gangs.
Right, I'm Ross Kemp and I'm back on the front line to talk about one of the dangerous crews of the AGS community, known as the Tech Crew. I'm unarmed. I've got no cable ties. Is it okay if I join you? Some of these guys are really big. I don't know if I should go in there. I've bought an offering of peace to try and solidify my relationship within the group. I hope it works. It seems to have worked. I'm in. I've managed to secure a meeting with the group leader, but it was a difficult process which required bribing these bodyguards with the latest hi-fi sound system. Thank you for agreeing to meet with me today. It's a difficult subject to breach, but could you tell us anything about the recent spate of thefts on the QSC KW122? Active PA speakers, please.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Alright, that would be the 100 watt edition. Have you anything to say?
I'm not sure speaking's our forte.
Things were heating up, so I decided to get out of there.
Welcome back to the Comedy Channel. Up next, bad lip reading.
Oh, I have 6 girlfriends. Racial clumps. Half a pint in the afternoon for breakfast.
£2.50.
Love it. Boogie. Huh? Ah, 57!
Lumpy!
What's 5 plus 5? Okay, probably 5 is 5. Probably 223?
Welcome back to AGS Channel 2. Up next, starring Ciaran Walsh as Liam King and Liam King as Ciaran Walsh, it is What Would Happen If the Headmaster Were Replaced by the Head Boys?
And only Deagle Double G.
Snoop Dogg.
Da 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 da. You know I'm mobbing with the D.R.E.
Yeah. You know the West Coast is back for all you suckers.
What? I'm burning it up. DPGC, you should be turning it up.
Morning, ladies. How are you naughty little tree boots doing this morning?
Morning, Miss King.
Could put a proper little notice in the notices this morning today. I need a notice about the student lad forum. So it starts today, and could all aspiring lads meet, Liam lad, that's me, at the back of the lecture theatre at lunch today, please. Sweet,
alright.
Cheers. Oh, that's brilliant. Yeah, well, hey, alright, okay. Oh, and yeah, one more thing. Could you change the timings of the school day a little bit? So, like, that maybe I could come in at about 11 in the morning, all that traffic, and a couple more rounds for Netflix, maybe? Yeah, alright. Oh, that'd be brilliant. Cheers. Alright. Cheers. Okay. Thank you. Bye. See you later.
Alright, come in. Alright, do you want to pull up a chair? Thanks for coming following our previous meeting.
No problem.
Yeah, so I'm pretty happy with how the library's panning out.
What's going on then?
Okay, boys, can we have some noise, please?
Sports in here. Go home with something to poke on. Locust on for the 2000. Coming real, it's the next episode.
Hold up.
New Sean.
Hey, boy, my ass, we be thinking we soft. We don't play. We
gon' rock it till the wheels fall off. Hold up, wait. Well, my d***s will be acting too bold. Take a seat. Hope you're ready for the next episode. Hey.
And coming up after the break, we take a look at what would happen if Ciaran Walsh, played by Liam King, were headmaster. Stay tuned on AGS Channel 2.
Roy, I'm here at the heart of the AGS school, and I'm here to see the snakes, commonly known for their dirty dog behaviour and football antics. The most prominent members are Presshead. Consistently, he's chicken out the packet. He was also said to be hit with the ladies. Oh, sorry, I mean he is known to hit ladies. Gollins. With the group's biggest girth, Gollins consistently grasps girls with a single objective in mind. Edam. They're consistently seen wandering the streets intoxicated, with no trousers on, with road cones over their head. Adam's jawline is said to be a thing of legends, something he has grown into since his early days. Ollie Cat, with the most, as they call them,
dry nuts.
Jenny. King Varia, who loves to flash off his gold watch and naughty whip. Olympic athlete Maurice Kareem cannot be seen setting new personal bests as he drives down Turn Furlong in his dad's BMW. Not forgetting the buffest in the group, Liam Ladd Buff King. My reporters are arranging an interview, so I'm going in. So boys, I've heard there's a turf war between you and the Flex. What's this about?
Butter.
Ciaran.
Someone say Ciaran.
Right, I've just spotted the Flex. They're over there. I'm going in.
This is AGS Channel 3's Panorama. We take a look this week at the men who steal socks.
So, Mr. Symington, what is your motivation to commit such acts?
White socks, black trousers, black shoes. It's a fashion disaster!
And when did you confiscate your first sock?
It was assembly. 2007. The gym. They had to take their shoes off. He came in blatant, wearing the white socks. Nobody could mistake. I had to bring that boy down.
And do you mind telling us where you keep the contraband?
No comment.
Nappy! Gnome! Gnome!
Yeah!
Mistress, she doesn't even make cake! Yeah, could you pick my knee, thanks? Yeah. I mean, that's not my way. Hello, Sammy Farmer?
Lumpy. I'm not a moron. What does he drink?
Goody. You're only 14. Pies full of walnuts.
The beef with the snakes was getting so heated that the flads retreated to a safe area. Also known as the lecture theatre. I'm going in.
But no, I'm sorry, 20 pints in one wedding, right?
Yeah, no,
So, I've heard a turf war of you and the snakes is over a special little someone. Who is she?
My prom date.
So, how many of you have kissed her then?
Oh,
and can you disclose the location where you kissed her?
Fever.
Oh yeah, fever.
So boys, where'd you spend most of your time then?
Well, personally, Croyd Bay.
Metro Bank.
Usually locked at home.
Australia.
Oh, normally I'm at Weight Watchers. Oxford.
Morning, miss. Could you give us your best impression of a sneeze, please? Achoo.
We know your Labrador is called Trevor. How are you making her look glam for our Tinder date tonight? And do you think she might get lucky?
A calm. She barks at me often. But I wish Trevor would snog 5 or 6 cows.
Achoo! Dogs cough a lot.
I'm here with a no wash boy. Coming alone for not washing for weeks on end and never getting their haircuts. They also wear their dad's clothing. Things have started to heat up, so I got out of there. As you saw, they just had their first wash thanks to Vickers in a month. They're known to be the most complicated and far-reaching group in the school. They've already received 2 expulsions and are known for their numerous blazes on school property.
Who's
squeezing me? Stop! I'm trying to hear, and this is how I'm going to do it. Yeah, come on, baby.
Really sorry, sir. Your rabbit has died. He's died.
Well,
no, he's dead.
Well, that happens to rabbits. Well, that, yeah. Well, the whole thing is good. She just jumps over the sofa and I'm there like, hello.
We actually got.
I hate cake. The farts that come are never the same.
Good morning. Hello, everybody, and warm felicitations to you all. This morning, I would love to treat you to the delightful lecture regarding the double standards for men and women throughout society. I am a feminist. The pervasive sexual objectification of women. This is what's wrong with society, ladies and gentlemen. This male here values her because of these. Step number 3. Ejaculation. But not the type you boys do on a Friday night, oh no. I'm talking about the ejaculation of misogynistic thoughts. Thank you. Thank you for listening.
Okay, games options today. We have group 1. We're going to do dancing in the hall with Mr. Holmes. Group 2, croquet on the headmaster's lawn with Mr. Rooney. Group 3, literary criticism, top field, Mr. Dean. And group 4, yeah, you're going to be with me and it's dressage on the school field.
After 3 months of negotiation, I managed to arrange a meeting with the Nibblers and the leader, Anthony Hutt.
Hey!
Oi, boys, I'm not scared. I'm not getting any of you.
F off, man. I'm in a world.
Oh, what?
I'm in a world.
No, what?
That's a big mate.
Seems as if insults is the best way to penetrate the group. So I'm gonna try it and see how it goes. Your mum's a. Dad's a. You're only a. Freaks me, aliens, girlfriends, you get some Sonic, and your mum eats curry with a
go.
It seems as if my nibbles have worked, and I've successfully infiltrated the group. Now I can start building relationships.
Too many nibbles.
No! We found him!
What's this?
We interrupt this program to bring you an emergency news broadcast. I'm Hugh Janus, and I'm Willie Fisterbottom. Our top story tonight. School left in shock after Mrs. Venning delivers no morals for any assemblies for an entire week. Initial reports show that students have no moral outlook on life and are just running savage. In other news, Mr. Sturgeon's authority has been crippled after someone has stolen his megaphone. Many students perishing in a fire as the only unlocked exit was the front door, which only staff are allowed to use. This comes in the same week as the school defending a serial killing ex-pupil in a controversial decision, claiming that at least he had his shirt tucked in. We now go live to a report of Ciaran losing his virginity off a spicy.
Hi there, Luke. I'm here on the scene and I'm about to lose my virginity to a spicy chicken burger. What do I ask for?
You ask for a spicy, you idiot.
Okay,
well,
I have a spicy.
Yes, would you like
a good one? Of course you have it, it's a spicy chicken burger.
What do you recommend, Liam?
I don't have nothing, I just have barbecue sauce.
What, do I take the top off?
Yeah, you take the top off. It's just a burger.
And then
you go and get...
Oh, salad!
Yeah, you get salad. Yes.
Do I need protection?
Yes, you need protection. What if we're here? No, eat the burger first, then clean up if anything goes wrong.
Do I just put it in?
Just put it in. Do you like it? It's decent.
Decent.
Pretty decent, isn't it? There you go.
Guys, we're filming.
Thanks for that, Ciaran. That's some interesting stuff. Coming up next, there have been reports of slavery as one student from AGS takes the ownership segment of the AGS learner too seriously.
That's quite a situation we've got there, Luke.
That's quite a situation we've got there, Luke, indeed, Ben. University Challenge winner cites AGS House Quiz as its most inspirational event.
And Mr. Ramsbottom finally reveals what it's like to work with Mr. Benel. Bearded students are worse than Hitler, claims Mr. Hearn.
And on the lighter side of things, a student actually found a house assembly useful.
This has been the AGS News.
Thank you and good night.
It's Friday.
side. So I reach for my 40 and I turn it up. Designated driver, take the keys to my truck. Hit the shop cause I'm faded. Honey's in the streets, say money, yo, we made it. It feels so good in my hood tonight. The summertime skirts and the guys in Kanai. All the gangbangers forgot about the drive-by. You gotta get your groove on before you go get paid. So tip up your cup and throw your hands up and let me hit the party. You're an OG Mac or a wannabe player. You see, the hood's been good to me ever since I was a lowercase G. But now I'm a big G. The girls see I got your money, $100 bills, y'all. If you were from where I'm from, then you would know that I gotta get mine in a big black truck. You can get yours in a 6-4. Whatever it is, the party's underway. So tip up your cup and throw your hands. Show us slow, and all they said was 6'8" he stood, and people thought the music that he made was good. They lived the DJ and Paul was his name. He came up to money, this is what he said. You and OG are gonna make some cash, sell a million records and we're making the dash. Oh, I'm buzzing the club.
This is how we do it.
South Central dancing like nobody does.
This is how we do it.
To all my neighbors, you got much favor.
This is how we do it.
I'll never come back.
This is how we do it.
Let's flip the track with the old school band.